So let's look at an example of deductive reasoning. So premise A is all mass creates gravity. And premise B is all objects have mass. Therefore, all objects create gravity. Because if all mass has gravity and all objects have mass, then they must create gravity. Notice that the logical conclusion has to be true if the two premises are true. We know, however, that this type of reasoning can lead to correct conclusions only when the general premises to which they are based are true. Let's look at another example. Premise A is I don't know math. Premise B is I can't learn math. Therefore, I shouldn't even bother trying to learn math. We see here that this reasoning leads to a false conclusion because premise A is false, and so is premise B. So even though the argument is easily structured in the same way, one leads to an accurate conclusion and one, this one, does not. Deductive reasoning is what scientists use when we make predictions for our general goals. Now let's go to Susan to talk about inductive reasoning.